Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Selfish person does, whether it be giving his body to be burned or giving all that he possesses to the poor, he will still do it in a selfish way of feeling. And he will be able to do this with extreme cunning, marvelous self-deception.
Thank you.
of it is this. You cannot teach a selfish person to be unselfish by any means. That is to say, whatever a selfish person does, whether it be giving his body to be burned or giving all that he possesses to the poor, he will still do it in a selfish way of feeling. And he will be able to do this with extreme cunning, marvelous self-deception.
And I said, here goes. And I said, here goes. And I said,
I just wanna be free.
Here goes.
I just wanna be free.
I said, here goes, And I said, I said,
I just wanna be free.
Here goes.
I just wanna be free.
I'm not sad.
Thank you.
but I'll find you.
You're lost.
something that is spontaneous. Your hair grows by itself. Your heart beats by itself. You breathe. You don't have voluntary control over these things. You've got to let go. You've got to be constantly trying to do what can happen.
Won't you hold me? Won't be lonely in the half-life.
losing myself for you.
Thank you. are so trapped by sentence structure, the verb has to have that subject. Therefore, you can't have a state of affairs in which there is just the verb, that is to say, knowing. They say, well, who is knowing? And it's as bad as arguing with a flat earth. Impossible. Because of the ruts of thought. Now, such a person can never be inventive. Why? Because he will never see a new pattern, a new structure. And he won't see one because he's thinking all the time. See what he's been taught to see. That's why academic psychology is always in a position of bafflement about learning. Because if learning is a process of converting new experience into the terms of what you've already learned, you never really learn at all. It's like, according to kind of a narrow-minded aerodynamics, bees cannot fly. When an inventor has an idea and all his colleagues say, oh, don't be silly. You can't do that. It just wouldn't work. Well, he says, I've tried it and done it. And very often they won't even try. They'll just say it can't be done. And you can get a fantastic doctor in the scientific. And you have to be terribly careful not to upset certain absolutely fundamental, strictly prejudices, which are the result of thinking.
Thank you.